When Bob saw the breadth of his domain, he wept, for there were no more worlds left for him to conquer. And with no interest in running the huge bureaucracy he'd now created, he gave that responsibility to another Bob and kept the fun parts of the job for himself, like a boss. We're going to go into the details, but just up front, I want to tell you the reason Bob Chapek got this gig is that he's willing to split the job with Bob Iger, for which the Disney company has set a precedent. Oh, this is a great story. Because yes, Bob Iger has actually become Walt frickin' Disney. I know that sounds blasphemous, but I think he's doing it. Just when we thought Bob Iger couldn't top himself. Wow. I mean, why be president of the United States when you can be the lovable uncle of the entire world and make so much money doing it? All right, so allow me to explain. Back in the day, for those of you who don't know your Disney history, if you're really into Disney, you know. Everyone has gone through that phase who loves Disney when they read all the biographies. You could just heck watch the Imagineering Project on Disney Plus. How many of you have? It's very good. In fact, if you really know your Disney, a lot of it everybody already knows. But anyway, the Disney company was actually run by two brothers. Walt Disney was the face of the company and the name of the company. How'd he swing that one? Poor Roy. And also its creative engine. Because remember, while Walt did create Mickey Mouse and he was an animator and he did direct, he quickly became more of an orchestrator at the company, overseeing other talent. And some people say taking credit for their ideas. But that's a whole other story. Yeah, you don't want to look too deeply into Walt Disney. Although Bob Iger also has his problems, which we're going to discuss. He's got a big one right here. It's crazy. But, like, he's basically Walt Disney was like Kevin Feige over at Marvel. And just like Feige, Walt was often listed as the sole producer on animated and live-action projects. And then there was his brother, Roy. And it was Roy's job to run the nuts and bolts of the company and find ways to pay for Walt's idea. The whole reason they did the ABC television show was to get money to make the theme parks. Then they eventually went on and bought ABC. Oh, it's fascinating. There's so much wonderful drama in the Disney company, and it continues. All right, so that's exactly what Bob Iger has now set up. Effective immediately. The fun starts now. Walt and Roy, Bob and Bob. And you know where else this also happened? Which I'm sure some of you are already typing down below if you know your Disney. Michael Eisner and Frank Wells. Both Roy and Frank were very good at their jobs, and a good balance the Disney company has proven to be crucial. So first it was Walt and Roy, and then of course Walt infamously passed away very suddenly from lung cancer, I believe. And it took a very long time for them to find a new creative engine for the company. Roy never found, he passed away before they could get somebody. Also, I have to say on a side note, I blame Walt Disney for this because he didn't raise either of his two daughters to take over the what really should be the family business. It certainly was when Walt was there, Walt and Roy. But he wanted his two daughters to be daughters. And then one of them married a college football star, and they made Ron Miller, and they made him the head of the Disney company when he just played football. It's very annoying to me that Walt Disney, well, I think Walt maybe thought to some degree he'd never die, or certainly not that early. But although he was crucial in lining up Ron to take over the company, because, it's that old-fashioned put my son-in-law in the company business. And boy, did the Disney company pay for that chauvinism. It's so bad. Okay, so anyway, so the balance was lost there. But then they kind of got it back with Michael Eisner, although Jeffrey Katzenberg was a very important part of that equation. And it's really three people who are responsible for bringing Disney back from the brink. And Jeffrey Katzenberg got so little credit for it, he actually left the company. He was so angry and started, that's one of the reasons he started DreamWorks. He was like, nobody appreciates me here. And they didn't. But Michael Eisner and Frank Wells were the public balance, right? But then Frank Wells tragically died in a helicopter crash in 1994. This has been a problem for a while. And Michael Eisner proved incapable of running the company without Frank Wells. And that's when Bob Iger got the gig, and Iger decided to do everything himself. He didn't have a partner, but now he feels he's ready for one. He's like, all right, no one can top this. I want to just do the fun stuff. Now, Bob Chapek, who is this guy? He's the head of Disney Parks Experiences and Products, and he will oversee the running of the Disney empire, while Bob Iger will continue to be in charge of the creative decisions at Disney. Whenever you imagine how great it would be to run the Disney company, that's what Bob Iger's going to do. And then everything else poor Bob Chapek has to do. But don't feel bad for Chapek, because he's getting a huge paycheck. And we'll talk more about Bob Chapek in a moment. He's somebody you shouldn't feel bad for under any circumstances. All right, but back to Iger. First, let's square him away. He'll be doing this creative stuff until the end of his current contract, which runs through the end of next year, literally December 31st, 2021. Will he then retire from Hollywood and run for president? I think that seeing how Mike Bloomberg is getting shredded for being a billionaire, amongst other things, to be fair. But, you know, I think people are done with their billionaire candidates. That seems to be the case. And also, Bob Iger has really done a poor job with the way the Disney employees have been treated. That's really like so many bad headlines that would come back to haunt him. Look at his wonderful legacy. Why ruin that? And there's even another thing that we're going to add to the list momentarily. So I don't think he's going to run for president. I think he's going to, and I don't see Bob Iger retiring, quite frankly. I think he's going to renegotiate his contract and either continue as the creative head of the company as it's Walt, or he could even just become a producer at the studio and make whatever movie he fancies, becoming like a Walt Disney Kevin Feige hybrid. Oh, that's amazing. You know, wow. But I think, although to be fair, to some degree, Bob Iger has earned this kind of freedom. And what a playground he has made for himself. Now, a lot of people in Hollywood were quite surprised that Bob Chapek got the gig. They felt there were other more qualified candidates. But considering the huge lines and great publicity that has come about for the Rise of the Resistance attraction, a situation that is not dying down, I'm sure that contributed to Chapek getting this gig. And again, a willingness to let Bob Iger keep all the fun parts of the job. I'm sure maybe this is how he sold it to him. He's like, you want to be my Frank Roy, Bob Chapek? And he's like, with that paycheck? Sure, I'd love to. But here's where it gets not so good. So as I'm sure you might recall, just a few months ago, Catherine Powell, who oversaw Disney parks for the U.S. and Paris, so she reported to Bob Chapek, she was forced to step down because Galaxy's Edge got off to a bad start. Now, of course, it's doing great, and Bob Chapek gets to run the company. Yeah, Bob Iger can't run for president because, you know, that's such a bad look, especially because it's a woman who'd been with the company for so long. It's bad. Now, speaking of bad, to the theme park fan community, Bob Chapek is their Kathleen Kennedy. It's that bad. He's widely hated for cutting corners as he tries to deliver Disney magic on the cheap, which you really can't do. Plus, Disney has a lot of money. They don't need to cut corners. And this greed of Chapek's has led the parks to become way overcrowded. It's horrific pictures online. Not very well run. And not a good situation for the staff. It's really kind of bleak, actually. And a lot of the original theming of the parks, made them very special, is being stripped away to make room for Disney's purchased IPs, which, to be fair, so far, very popular. But why can't we have both, right? Again, to save money and time to get these attractions up as fast as possible, Chapek has liked to replace rather than expand. Which is makes a lot of really, you know, a lot of Disney fans very upset. Bob Chapek's really been living on the edge, so we'll see who takes over for him in that division. But speaking of Kathleen Kennedy, well, Bob Iger has squared away the entire Marvel division, consolidating the whole thing under Kevin Feige, selecting successors to John Lasseter for both Disney and Pixar Animation, and splitting them up again. And Sean Bailey is continuing to successfully run the live-action division. It's going to be up to Chapek to decide who takes over for Kathleen Kennedy when her contract ends also at the end of 2021. Although, surely, in Bob Iger's new creative position, he will help make that decision as well. He just doesn't have to take responsibility. That will fall on Chapek. Although, clearly, the choice is Jon Favreau. So, luckily for Chapek, all he has to do is just sign what's probably going to be a very big check. So is it Disney that keeps winning, or is it Bob Iger, right? Because again, Chapek likely got this gig, not because he's the best man for the job, or, you know, I hope, or woman, right? But the best man for the job, or was it because he was willing to give this situation to Iger? He's willing to be his Frank or Roy. But I have to say, so far it doesn't seem like Chapek is at the level of Roy or Frank. So what do you think? Bob Iger's great, though. He's great. All right, so what do you think? And also, I think that Bob Iger has maybe put I don't know. You wouldn't think you could run the theme parks into the ground, but Chapek has done like a pretty good job putting them in danger. But they're making a lot of money. That's like the problem we've had with Disney for a while, right? So incredibly successful, but like at what cost? Are the insides rotted? But when will we ever see any repercussions to that? Seemingly never. All right, share your thoughts down below, subscribe today, and of course, as always, you can check out some more videos right now.